A very good day to you. I'm Hank Gross, MidHudsonNews.com. It's Wednesday, June 1st. The news today brought to you by the Galleria at Crystal Run. One-term State Senator Michael Martucci announced on Tuesday that he will not seek re-election this fall. Stepping away from the race is a very difficult decision for me because it's been an honor of a lifetime to serve communities across four counties, he said. The redistricting process would have pitted the Republican Martucci against Senator James Skoufis, a Democrat. Martucci said when he first declared his intention to seek a second term, the Senate district he petitioned was completely different from the one that exists today. On May 2nd, Megan McDonald would have turned 40. Her life was abruptly ended when she was murdered on March 15, 2003, and her body was found in a field off a back road in the town of Wallkill. 19 years later, the police are continuing to work the case as her family believes it will be solved by year's end. Megan's sister, Karen Whalen, has a new message regarding her sister's killer.
We know that our message must get through to a handful of people. The police have mentioned in other interviews that there was another person in the car besides Megan and the killer that night. This is the chance for his family, that other person in the car, for his family to do the right thing. They have limited time before someone else, like the coward, writes the narrative for them. They have a chance to keep their loved one's legacy intact since there was somebody else there that night.
Megan's car was found in a parking lot of an apartment complex not far from where the body of the 5 foot 2 inch tall, 100-plus-pound young woman was found. Police in the city of Newburgh are investigating the discovery of a body in a garage at 84 East Parmenter Street. The body was found in the early afternoon on Tuesday, and a police spokeswoman said the case is an ongoing investigation. Police were scouring the scene looking for clues into the circumstances surrounding the death. More news right after this.
Find over 100 retailers allowing you to spend hours shopping safely at the Galleria at Crystal Run. Enjoy the big brands and the diverse selection of family-owned stores all in one location. The Galleria at Crystal Run offers dining options for everyone with Fuji, 110 Grill, Allen's Mediterranean Grill, and Peru Cuisine. Discover the Mid-Hudson Valley's premier shopping, dining, and entertainment destination, the Galleria at Crystal Run. For more information, follow us on Instagram, Facebook, or visit GalleriaCrystalRun.com.
Three more people have died in the Hudson Valley from COVID-19 as the number of new cases of the virus declines dramatically, the State Department of Health says. There was one new death each in Orange, Ulster, and Greene counties on Friday, the last date for which statistics were gathered because of the holiday weekend. New cases of the virus, which had reached close to 2,000 in one day not long ago, declined to 426 at last count. Vaccinations and being outdoors in the warm spring weather may be among the factors in reducing the cases. A Newburgh man stopped by state police while driving on Washington Street in the city of Newburgh has been charged with giving officers a false name and DWI. The man who identified himself as Jose Moran was stopped just before 7 p.m. on May 29th. The vehicle, a 1997 Nissan Maxima, had a fraudulent New Jersey temporary registration and no insurance. He gave troopers an OSHA safety card with his photo and name, but officers learned it was a false name. He was later identified as 48-year-old Abner Galvez of the city of Newburgh. Police charged him with felony driving while ability impaired, DWI, felony aggravated unlicensed operation, possession of a forged instrument, forgery, and false personation. He was released on an appearance ticket. I'm Hank Gross, MidHudsonNews.com. The news today brought to you by the Galleria at Crystal Run.